besides this point, it's not gonna have any mouth sounds for people that do not like mouth sound. This is gonna be a positive affirmation video, and I hope you enjoy. Let's get right into it. Myself personally, I get anxious because I think not if they love me, but when they would leave, when they would leave, when they would leave. Sometimes, and it doesn't get spoken about a lot, there are people that are too knowing, people that know themselves too well, people that evaluate themselves too hard and think about their mental health much too frequently. As good as it is to know yourself, sometimes that can be very damaging. Try to learn who you are as you go. Don't just sit down and think about everything that's happened to you in one sitting, in 1 week, in 1 month, in 1 year, in 2 years. You've been here for how many years now? And I've gotten all these experiences through these years. Healing is slow. Things that are fast often go bad. Things that happen too quickly can have negative aftermaths. If you're the kind of person that is doing a weight loss journey, don't stress yourself out if things are not going fast. Your body has been here for years, and it's taken you years to be the person that you are now with your current weight. So if things are not going as fast as you would like them in a month, in a week, in a year, just know that it took time. Take time for yourself. For those of us worrying about financial situations, ask yourself, am I using my time wisely? Am I sitting down and planning? Am I thinking about doing these things and not doing them? Am I just thinking? Am I just aware of things that have to be done, but I'm not doing them? Doing them. Are you thinking of everything, but not trying to fix your past traumas? Do you recognize the bad situations that have formed you in negative ways? And if so, have you just recognized them and are you sitting with them? Or are you recognizing them and making a plan to overcome these things and be a better person for yourself, for your friends, for your family, for those rooting for you? People are rooting for you. A lot of us have friends that we want our friends to reach out to us more often, but are you reaching out to them? Things are both ways. Are you reaching out to your friends? Are you checking up on them? And if you are, and if you aren't getting the response you want, are you not getting as frequent responses? Be honest with your friends. Say, hey friend, I'm a little emotional and I question things sometimes or all the time. Do you mind answering these questions for me if it isn't a bother? Do you care about me? Can you tell me a reason why you're my friend? True friends won't have a problem answering you these simple questions. Some friends might be confused. Some friends might find it weird, but remember, they are all going through their own things. A lot of people aren't in tune with their emotions. And because you are and they are not, it is not their fault and it is not your fault. Remember, everyone is going through their own experiences at home, in their minds, their past, their present. They're thinking about their future. Everyone is thinking the same things. Some people are genuinely happy and don't worry about their mental health at all. and that's great, but that's not everyone. If you have friends that seem popular, always happy, everything's going right for them, and it's not for you at this moment, just remember, things change. Be happy for them. Don't start being jealous or envious or comparing yourself. A lot of us don't say it, but sometimes we get jealous of our friends. Sometimes we have, you know, negative thoughts. It happens. The best thing to do is check yourself. Check yourself and your thoughts, okay? We're not perfect. And you're not a bad person if you have one or two bad thoughts. And if it continues, take a step back. Take a step back from that person and analyze yourself. Why am I thinking this way of my friend? Why am I upset that she's popular, he's popular, they're popular? Why do they have everything going right for themselves? Don't think about anyone else because your life is yours and no one else's, okay? Yours and no one else's. I want to talk to the people that can recognize their traumas right now. Those of you that know exactly what situation or which situations have formed you to be cold or colder or not receptive of love. What are you doing to change yourself and to be that happy person you once were or that person you want to be? Me, for example, all of my friends are super jolly, super happy, and then you look at me, I'm very laid back, very chill. At some point, I probably would have acted like them. There was a time that I questioned, why do I have these people around me? Although you may not act exactly like your friends, you are your friends, and you are examples of one another. So if you're hanging around happy, jolly people, and you might be quiet, at some point you will become happy and jolly. And maybe you are, but you're scared to show it. Just remember, the people you keep around you are a reflection of yourself, And it is true that sometimes you might have some friends that have done wrong things, a lot of your friends, and you just happen to be that good person, or whatever that may be. And people tell you, well, you're a reflection of your friends, you're just like them. And you think, I'm just not judgmental. That's amazing, that's great, but make sure that you are taking care of yourself in the process. You might not know it, but things, small things, catch on. Be a great person, but take care of yourself first and foremost. I would like to talk to those of us that have been the perfect friend, but somehow, countless times we've been done wrong. Now we ask ourselves, are we worthy of these amazing people that have entered my life recently? You've had a surge of good things happening to you, and you're starting to think, what is happening? Why is this happening to me? Do I deserve this? I want you to stop. I want you to just pause and think, why are these the thoughts that are in my head? Thoughts manifest into bigger things. As my friend says, things you say and things you think can become or can form into existing things. So rather than thinking, why is this happening to me? It's only a matter of time. I start to think, it's about time. I do deserve this. sure that it stays? How can I make sure that it stays? How can I keep the blessings flowing? Flowing. Be happy for yourself. Be happy. Be happy for yourself. You don't need a group of friends. You don't need that movie life. You don't need a squad. Maybe one or two friends right now is what you need mentally. Maybe one or two friends is what you are capable of dealing with right now. And maybe another friend will come along, and then another. And as your mental health gets better, more people will gravitate towards you. Another thing my friend says, I quote my friends nowadays because I'm just so blessed to finally have a group of amazing people that understand me and take their time to tell me their feelings and how I make them feel and how they make me feel. They say that, or she says that. She says that you need to just focus in the present and be happy for the things that are slowly coming into your life, very slowly, because you don't want to get overwhelmed at once. You don't want to get overwhelmed. Tell your friends what's wrong. Tell your parents what's wrong. It doesn't matter if they're gonna hurt your feelings. It doesn't matter if you know how it will end. It's better out than in. Speak up. If they leave, they weren't meant to be there. If how you are feeling, if how they made you feel is enough to make them leave, if they have done you wrong and they are leaving because you bring it to their attention, well, they're just not meant to be in your life now, are they? True friends listen. True friends stay. And if they don't stay, that might not have meant they weren't a true friend. That just means maybe they don't have the emotional capacity to deal with your emotions for this moment. Maybe you are close to figuring out your emotional baggage and you are at a level where people are not at yet. So you being so open and asking these questions and wanting people to be upfront, some people just aren't there quite yet. And some people just don't want to deal with you, period. Those people, it's good riddance. You don't lose anything. People who don't have time for you, you don't have time for them. Choose yourself. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video.